We're talking to boxing champion JAMEL Herring. He's about to fight Shakur Stevenson. It's a fight Terrence Crawford told me that he hates, and he's not going to watch, but he will watch, but he hates the fight. What do you think about fighting a guy that you know from the gym that I'm sure you've sparred even, correct?
I mean, it's just like Shakur said a while ago, it's just business. For me, it's nothing personal. It just, like I said, it's a good fight for the division. It's a good fight for boxing. But it ain't nothing personal or not. But I understand and respect what Bud, you know, what Bud stands at, because, you know, he got love for us both.
And that's awesome. It's a big fight, championship fight. You defended your title not once, not twice, not three times, but four times. It's not easy. It's harder to...
Ellie, you know where I come from, man. Like, I ain't never have it easy, but I'm just grateful. Feel me? I'm grateful. Even to being, not just defend my title, but still being big fights. You know what I mean? So far, it's been a big year for me. So I don't complain. You know, I'm just grateful.
By the way, I have a great memory. And one of the reasons I wanted to interview you, because we spoke when I interviewed Flores and his dad. And the dad said,
I ain't nothing against that, man.
You don't have anything against anybody.
But, like, I don't, like, honestly.
You love everybody.
I don't even know where it came from. They said I sneaked this and whatever. But, like, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, I'm just glad at least Gabe is, you know, he's functional. He's doing all right. Because, come on, Ellie, I've been there. I mean, look at the Shabako fight. I was in bad shape.
I remember.
Shabako fight. Bad shape after that.
And you came back and you're a champion.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, like, you know, I wish them for the best for him and his father. You know what I mean? So, I'm not going to respond with nothing, you know, no craziness, but it is what it is. They feel like, I sense them against them, whatever.
Nah, you're a good dude. But let me ask you this. Tank and Rowley, what do you think?
Man, that's crazy ass fight.
It's a good fight. I like it.
I mean, I'm more interested in the build up, because you know they're gonna
it's no face offs for that one as well. Nah. They're not gonna let them, if they have a face off, there's no fight.
Yeah, that's gonna be crazy, especially like in a lightweight division when they get no face off. That's something you only see really in the heavyweight division. But like, I mean, like I said, man, it's gonna be a good one. That's a good matchup. Of course, you want to lean towards Tank, who's the more, you know, seasoned pro at the time. But like, you can never underestimate somebody's hunger, and like Rowley's been asked for this fight forever now, feel me? So, I mean, I'm gonna support it. I'm either order it or I'm either attend to it. So I'm not gonna knock it.
Okay.
And shout out to my guy Leonard Elby. You know what I mean? Leonard out here doing his thing.
What about Canelo and Plant? Less than a month away.
Shoot, another one. Like, of course we wanna side with Canelo because it's Canelo Alvarez. But like I said, my man Caleb
was your Olympic teammate. He was alternated that year.
My guy, and he ain't laying down for nobody. So like I said, I mean, Again, I'm going to look forward to it. I don't think it's going to be easy as people may think. Because like I said, Caleb is determined. Caleb got a lot, you know, he got a chip on her shoulder. And that press conference was crazy.
You saw Canelo's reflexes? I was impressed.
Yeah, but like I said, man.